So we have Eugene Kim, the writer and director of Cherry. We have Ryan Agabao, the actor, and the cinematographer, Jeremy Castillo. Awesome. Round of applause. Awesome.
How's it going?
Good. I heard your screening just took place went amazing.
Right here. It was a good turnout.
Yeah?
It's a lot of our crew, cast and crew, but yeah, it was a good turnout.
So how many of you attended that screening? Raise your hand. Yeah. Awesome. So a good 10% or so. Meaning, I want you to educate and let these people know what your film is about.
Okay, so Cherry... So the idea of Cherry came while my wife and I were laying in bed talking about what it was like growing up. She's from Hawaii. I'm from out here in like Daly City, South City. So we were talking about the music scene and all that stuff. And she kind of had like a similar upbringing through like middle school and high school, just going to like a lot of, I don't know, garage parties with, you know, a lot of the Filipino families with the food. I'm not Korean, by the way. Or I mean, I'm not Filipino, I'm Korean. But I grew up around a lot of Filipinos, which made me want to make the lead a Filipino dude, because I was talking to my cinematographer and editor, Jeremy, and we're like, for this to feel authentic, we have to make it Filipino. So it was kind of difficult finding someone that was around during that time. Luckily, we had Ryan.
And he also can grow bangs.
That was important. He could grow the perfect bang that just drops like this. So, and he was kind authentic. He's authentically a part of that scene. You know, he was always out there b-boying and doing all the stuff. So we're like, we should just get him to play himself. So that's that's kind of how that whole thing came about. And like I said during the screening, we wanted to make something that felt kind of like the Wonder Years or like Freaks and Geeks for our community. So that's how that came about.
Awesome. Ryan and Jeremy, I would love to just hear a little bit about your story. Like, how did you get to be an actor, whether it be in this film or if it's something you're pursuing, and same with you being a cinematographer.
Like, cool. I mean, I can start.
Sure.
So, no, I had no intention of ever being an actor.
Oh, hello? Oh, there we go. I had no intention of ever being an actor, but it, you know, maybe, I don't know if other Filipinos in here, but if they feel the same way, but I've always dreamed of being an actor, right? And I've always like acted at like family parties or like sang and danced and did these little shows. And, you know, I've always wanted to be like, you know, on TV one day. And then so my buddy here, he approached me one day and, you know, he's always coming up with these crazy ideas. And he says, hey, I've got this idea. And if you want to do it, it'll change your life. And I was like, what's this dude talking about? Like, is this some like trippy drug or something? Like, what could change my life? And then so he drops Cherry on me, and I'm like, damn, that's fire. So
well, I think I showed him a picture of Kai, and I was like,
how many of you are familiar with Kai?
Yeah.
Hey. So I was like, this is your life. I was like, I'm gonna make a movie about your life. And he was like, what are you talking about? I was like, you just got to cut your hair how I tell you to, and we're good. That's how it all
started. And that sucked, too, because, I mean, I had my hair was perfect at that time, too, and I had to, like, buzz it all down. I just now got it back, so.
Right on. Jeremy?
What was the question again?
How did you get into doing what you do?
Oh, basically, I've been doing this for a while now. I initially started with, like, skating with my friends. Some of my friends are here. But I broke my leg. I wasn't good at skating, so I became the video guy. And then I found my way into the editing room with one of my best friends here. I was his editor. He directed a film called All About Dad that did really, really well. And then you start signing contracts for corporate gigs and stuff like that. So we start working corporate gigs for a long time, and then eventually we go like, all right, well, it's time to get back to work, you know? So that's kind of where this all kind of came about. We were all like, we got to get on a cycle. We got to start doing this, start telling our stories. Mm-hmm. And that's where we are today.
Beautiful. So, and then your story. How you got
film?
Into directing. Yeah.
Same thing. We all went to school. I was just telling these guys earlier, but we went to school at San Jose State. And we kind of discovered that the school had a closet full of equipment that no one was using, which kind of, we were like, why are we in the film department and we're not making any movies? So we just started slowly playing with equipment. We started working on Mark's feature, which was shot on the HVX with weird lens adapters and stuff like that.
Elitis.
Yeah, yeah, that one. And it kind of trickled down from there. We're like, man, we could actually make stuff. So instead of, well, we were still partying, but we would make films and then party at night and then wake up the next day and make films. So that's kind of how it all started. San Jose State, I guess. Go Spartans.
So has being Filipino or Asian helped you or hurt you in the process of pursuing your career?
I guess I'll start. I think a little bit of both. I think back in the days, it was a lot tougher being Asian. I couldn't find any work. We're producing a lot of our own stuff. And I feel like maybe in the last like 5 years or so, it's kind of become trendy to be diverse. Mm-hmm. So I've definitely noticed that in the past years, it's helped me get work in a way. Sometimes in a way that's a little weird, like, hey, you're ethnic, you should do this. So I don't know. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but I think the important thing is that there is a platform now, like what Diane was saying, there's no excuse to not make things because you have your YouTube, you have your Vimeo, you have so many different platforms kind of doing digital, you know, deals and stuff like that. So if you want to make a story, if you want to tell your story of your upbringing, like, you should just do it because I think there's definitely an audience. I mean, even with Cherry, we're like, who wants to watch a movie about Daly City in like from like 1998 till 2000? And we're like, this is weird. This is just literally a fun project just for our group of friends. And then Quentin, I think he used to manage Kai. He somehow got in touch with me. Mm-hmm. And I was like, this is crazy because they want me to put their music in my movie. And this is kind of like the people that inspired the film. So there's definitely a crowd that wants to hear these stories. 100%.
And then, I mean, if you're saying, like, the question was, being Filipino, has it helped me in life and in my career? So I actually own my own business. So I do printing. I was telling you earlier, right? So I feel like it's kind of helped me. Like, I feel like we've been held down and oppressed for so long that just being that brown character and that person, like, this white guy's like, hey, I, you know, let me support you. I'm going to feel good about myself. So, but, you know, but seriously, I mean, it's more like also, you know, they kind of know that we're hard workers. You know what I mean? So they know that we're going to deliver what we say we're going to do. We can't take any risk. You know, we've got to follow through with what we say we're going to do. So I feel like it's helped me.
And he also prints shirts for San Miguel and Red Horse. So yeah. Shout out.
Shout out to them.
From my experience, a little bit of yes, a little bit of no, but whenever you talk to someone, they always go like, oh, you're Filipino? I have a Filipino friend. You should meet him. So that's it. Yeah. So no, we're all connected, and everybody should spend their dollar with their people.
Yeah.
Right. And so...
Castillo, you know, 2020.
All right. You know, when as creators, you know, you want to create, but then again, there are those moments where you just get stuck and it's hard to get back into momentum. Like, what do you do to recharge that inspiration to whatever it is you want to create?
I think that's, for anyone that's a filmmaker, that's always the difficult thing, is finding the money to do what you love doing, because the older we get, we can't just keep, you know, spending all of our time making films and not making any money off of it or getting paid to do it. So having a close group of friends, whether they're buddies that you met in school or people that are just interested in film, just people that want to work hard and believe in you, I think that's important to kind of just build your little entourage of people that are always willing to work, and getting people that will push you, because we all get lazy and we're like, oh, we want to make this project. I wrote this feature, and then you kind of go, okay, cool. Just sits on your laptop, nothing happens. But you know, getting friends that really push you and say, look, I'll give you a couple $100, I'll give you $1,000, I'll give you $500, and kind of throwing it around in our little group of you know, in our circle, like we're working on a short film for Mark next that we're trying to shoot in July. So just doing whatever it takes, using whatever gear. Like before, we'd be like, oh, we can't shoot this because we don't have an Alexa, and we don't have this, we don't have that. And we're finally at a point where we're like, you know what, we can make it look good with what we got. We just have to have a good story and just keep making stuff. I think that's pretty much what it is.
An analogy is if you're sitting in your car and it's broken down, no one's going to help you push it. But if you get out and start pushing your car, everyone's going to start helping you push your car. Mm. So push your car.
Wow, that's deep.
And Jeremy Castillo.
I was working on that all week. Stole it from Chris Rock.
Cool. So for the sake of time, we just want to say thank you, you guys, for being a part of this conversation.